بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، الحمد لله. We have finished the first principle, which is regarding Islam, and today we will start al-Iman. However, before starting Iman, I wanted to talk about the issue of Iman itself. So we're not going to talk about the pillars of Iman and so on. That will come in the following lessons. But today I really wanted to talk about and have an in-depth study of the issue of Iman. And what I'll be using for this is, for today, just one reference actually, which is a revision guide written by Sheikh Saleh Sindi. It was something we studied in Medina. It says, Mada Tawheed, the topic of Tawheed, Li Fadayt Sheikh Saleh Sindi. I don't know if you can, it's not a book, as you can see, we don't have, it's not even a book, it's stuff that we had to print out, and we bought it within the uni, so I don't know if you're able to get it, but inshallah, I'm going to try to talk about the topic of Tawheed, because it's really in-depth, actually, it's really in-depth, and it's kind of mentioned a lot of the things I've read outside anyway, so I'm going to try my best to stick to this, and even try to translate as close as I can to what's already written. Obviously, this, you know, I'm translating as I'm going along, as I'm reading, so it won't be the most precise 100%, but inshallah, close enough. So the Sheikh says al-Iman, so the topic of Iman. He says Iman is the highest thing which is sought, and it is the highest objective that every believer strives to establish. And for this reason, researching regarding this topic has a high status. Verily, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah has said, رَتَّبَ اللَّهُ فِي كِتَابِهِ عَلَى الْإِيمَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered in his book upon Iman, نحو مئتي خصلات, approximately 100 qualities, i.e. approximately mentioning 100 qualities of Iman. كل خصلة منها خير من الدنيا وما فيها. Every quality in it or from it, every quality from it is better than the world and what is in it. And this was mentioned by Ibn Qayyim in Ad-Da' wa Ad-Dawa, page 198, with slight changing in wording. So now, then the Sheikh, he says, ولحصول الاضطرار في هذا الباب فلا بد من معرفته. And due to confusion in this chapter, then we must know and understand it. The definition of Iman. Many of the people of knowledge have defined Iman linguistically as التصديق. التصديق. تا صاد دال يا قاف. Which you can translate to believe. However, the correct opinion is that Iman is not a synonym for tasdiq from every aspect, but rather it is tasdiq and something extra. Rather, it is tasdiq and something extra. Now, what is that something extra? We're gonna get to that in a second. And from those who pointed this out was Al-Raghib Al-Asfahani, where he said, Al-Raghib Al-Asfahani, where he said, قال تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُؤْمِنٍ لَنَا وَلَكُنَّا صَادِقِينَ. And you are not بِمُؤْمِنٍ, you are not a mu'min of us, so you can translate that too, you are not believing us, وَلَوْ كُنَّا صَادِقِينَ, even if you were truthful. This is in Surah Yusuf, ayah number 17. This is what the brother said to to the father Yaqub when they lied about Yusuf being eaten by wolf. They said, وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُؤْمِنٍ لَنَا وَلَوْ كُنَّا صَادِقِينَ, that you are not going to be believing us even if you were truthful. So Raghu al-Asfahani, he says, قَالَ تَعَالَ وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُؤْمِنٍ لَنَا وَلَوْ كُنَّا صَادِقِينَ قِيل, it is said, مَعْنَاهُ بِمُصَدِّقٍ لَنَا, that you will not believe us, you will not have tasdeeq in us. إِلَّا أَنَّ الْإِيمَانَ هُوَ التَّصْدِيقُ الَّذِي مَعَهُ أَمَن, except that the reality is that iman is that tasdeeq, that belief, which has tranquility with it. Okay, so the extra that you're talking about is that tranquility. And you know, the point being is that even if the father says, yeah, I believe you, he's not fully content in his heart. And if you know the story, then you know, obviously, because the shirt wasn't ripped. And if a wolf was to attack Yusuf, then the shirt would have been damaged, but it wasn't. So that true belief wasn't there. So it's not just believing, but it's believing with contentment. So the Sheikh, after mentioning Raghib al-Asfahani's statement, he says, and this is clear because the people do not use the word iman in every matter, but rather it means at-tasdiq ma'a itmi'nan. It means to believe with your tranquility. فأقرب ما يمكن أن يعرف به الإيمان في اللغة. So the closest thing and how we can, or how iman can be defined linguistically, is التصديق بأمر غيبي. To have تصديق, to believe in a unseen matter. Whilst being content regarding what you have been informed, or regarding the information you've been informed about. The word you is not there, but the thing which has been informed about now. I'm trying to translate, you know, as close as I can, inshallah, to this. Maybe in the future, I might even just translate this whole section. To be honest, the whole book is amazing. The whole revision guide. Just for a few references. And I'll try to mention the references, the same references as the Sheikh. I'm just using what the Sheikh has used. I don't want to go out of it because honestly, it's really good. The statement for Raghib al-Asfahani, that's in Mufradat al-Fadhul Qur'an al-Kareem, page 26. And after this definition, which is given right now, in the footnotes, the Sheikh wrote, look at Kitab al-Iman by Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Look at the Book of Iman by Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Okay, then the Sheikh carries on, he says, Shara'an. Islamically, أجمع السلف الصالح, the pious predecessors have all agreed, they have consensus. ومن بعدهم, as those who came after them, من أهل السنة, from أهل السنة, على أن الإيمان قول وعمل, that إيمان is قول وعمل. إيمان is speech and action. And in the footnotes, the Sheikh writes, this the ijma' has been transmitted by Shaykh al-Islam on the authority of Imam al-Shafi'i. Look at volume 4, page 209. Volume 7, page 209. So the Salaf al-Salih have all agreed, and those after them from Ahl al-Sunnah, that iman is speech and action. وَيُرِيدُونَ بِذَلِكَ, and what they mean by that, قَوْلُ الْقَلْبِ, and I'm explaining it. Okay, and you'll understand that qawl wa amal, if many of the salaf, the Sheikh's going to mention, they mention this, yeah? So, that's basically summarizing. To summarize, it's qawl wa amal. What does that mean? The Sheikh's going to explain it now. So he says, وَيُرِيُّنَ بِذَلِكَ, they intend by this, qawlu al-qalbi wal-lisan, the statement of the heart and the tongue, وَعَمْلُ al-qalbi wal-jawarih, and the action of the heart and the limbs. And the actions of the heart and the limbs. قول القلب, now we're explaining this even more. The statement of the heart, فهو إيقانه, then it is its certainty, وتصديقه, and its belief in Allah and in His messengers, and in everything which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has informed of, and everything which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has informed. So if any man disbelieves in anything which the Prophet, which the Messenger came with, even if it is one khabar, one his information or hadith, he is not considered, or he is not called a mu'min. Allah says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ مَاتُوا Sorry, ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا Verily, the believers are only those that believe in Allah and His Messenger, and then they do not have doubt. Surah Hujurat, ayah 15. وَقَوْلُ اللِّسَانِ And a statement of the tongue, هُوَ التَّلَفُظُ بِالشَّهَادَتِينَ It is declaring the two testimonies. كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى As Allah says, قُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ Say, we believe in Allah. Surah Baqarah, ayah 136. وَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ And the Prophet صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ said, أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أُقَاتِلَ النَّاسَ حَتَّى يَقُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ I have been commanded to fight the people until they say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ This Bukhari hadith number 385 and Muslim hadith number 21. And in a narration with in Muslim, أُمِرْتُ نُقَاتِلَ النَّاسَ حَتَّى يَشْهَدُوا أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ I have been commanded to fight the people until they testify لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَيُؤْمِنُوا بِي And they believe or have iman in me وَبِمَا جِئْتُ بِهِ And with what I have been commanded and وَبِمَا جِئْتُ بِهِ And what I have come with and what I have come with. That's in Sahih Muslim, hadith number 21. عَمَلُ الْقَلْبِ The actions of the heart. وَهِيَ أَعْمَالُ الْقُلُوبِ These are the actions of the heart, كالتوكل, تَوَكُّل, reliance, وَالْمَحَبَّةِ love, خَشْيَةِ or إِنَابَةِ returning back to Allah. وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكَ And other than that. قَالَ تَعَالَى إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ Very the believers are those If Allah is mentioned, وَجِيَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ Their hearts are full of fear. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا And if the ayat, if his ayat, Allah's ayat are recited, then they increase in iman. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكُّلُونَ And upon their Lord, they have tawakkul. Surah Anfal, number 2. وَعَمَلُ الْجَوَارِحِ And the actions of the limbs, الْأَعْمَالُ ظَاهِرَ بِالْبَدَنِ The apparent actions from the body, like salah and the physical actions that you do. And then the Sheikh he says makes a point. He says, "يتعلق بتعريف الإيمان تنبيهات." يتعلق بتعريف الإيمان تنبيهات. تنبيهان. Relating to the definition of iman, two points. الأول, the first. عامة العلماء يقسمون الإيمان إلى قسمة رباعية بالطريقة التي وضحت أعلى. Majority of the scholars they split إيمان into a splitting of four in the manner which was explained above. Obviously, the book is above, or with you guys if I wasn't translating and I was speaking to you previously. وقد قسمها الإمام ابن تيمية رحمه الله. And verily, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he has split it في الواسطية, in his عقيدة واسطية, قسمة خماسية, in five parts. Okay. In definition, in the reference you wrote, look at explanation of عقيدة واسطية, volume 2, page 229 to 230. فزاد عمل اللسان. What he increased was the words عمل اللسان, the actions of the tongue. So he increased the actions of the tongue. ومن المعلوم, and it is known, أن عمل اللسان داخل في عمل الجوارح, إذ اللسان من الجوارح. And it is known that the actions of the tongue, it enters under the actions of the limbs, because the tongue is from the limbs. In other words, عمل اللسان would be, if I, أستغفر الله, سبحان الله, الحمد لله, لا إله إلا الله أكبر, action of the tongue. But that's included in actions of the limbs because the tongue is a limb. So, you know, there's no difference in between those definitions. And then the Sheikh says on the next line, still the first point, he says, عُرِفَ الْإِيمَانِ بِتَعْرِيفٍ فِيهِ قِسْمَةٌ ثَلَاثِيَةٌ Iman has been defined with a definition which has three parts. وَهُوَ اعتقاد بالجنان وقول باللسان وعمل بالجوارح والأركان. It is belief with the heart and speech with the tongue and actions with the limbs and the pillars. إضاحات. وقد جاء هذا التعريف لعدد من السلف, and this definition has come from many of the Salaf, منهم أبو ثور, from them أبو ثور. And in the reference, look at مجموع الفتاوى, volume 7, page 387 to 388. And then he says, وَاشْتَهَرَ عِنْدَ الْمُتَأَخِّرِينَ. And that's what has been become famous with the later scholars. So the Sheikh is saying that, look, some people have 23, some 4, some 5, all the same. You know, that's why when you summarize it, قول وعمل, خلاص, that's summarized all the definitions now. If you, how you want to explain it, 3, 4, 5, that's, you know, that's, it's all the same thing. It's just the way you depend, you know, how you want to explain it. 3 is what's more famous now, but what the majority of ulama have explained it as is the 4. Now, الثاني, the second point. تعريف الإيمان بأنه قول وعمل أصبح من شعائر السنة. The definition of إيمان, that it is قول وعمل, speech and action, it has become from the symbols of the Sunnah. قال الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله, الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية said, ولهذا كان القول, and that's why the statement إن الإيمان, verily إيمان, قول وعمل, is statement and action, عند أهل السنة, according to أهل السنة, من شعائر السنة. It is from the شعائر, it is from the symbols of the Sunnah. It mentioned this مجموع الفتاوى, volume 7, page 308. Now, there's a third point which I want to mention. Okay, the Sheikh doesn't mention this, but I want to mention, Sheikh Arsami mentioned this. Let me get it. You know, this you can write on the side, inshallah. Sheikh Arsami does mention this point. Let me write this on the side. Bismillah. I don't really want to go, I don't really want to add too much, but here and there I might just add something if I see that it is something which is beneficial, inshallah. The Sheikh, he says, Sheikh Usaymi, Iman linguistically has two meanings. The first, general, and that is the religion which Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been sent with. Verily, it is called Iman. And its reality, Islamically, firm conviction and belief inwardly and outwardly in Allah out of worship for Him with the legislation which has been revealed upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon the station of Mushahada al Muraqaba. The words not coming to Mushahada. It can be seen, you can be seen, a maraqa supervision. So if Iman is generally mentioned, then it has the same meaning as Islam and Ihsan. The other meaning is al-i'tiqadat al-batina, the inner beliefs. فَإِنَّهَا تَسَمَّى إِيمَانًا. That is also known as, or that is also called Iman. And this is the meaning, and what is intended, and this meaning is intended if it is accompanied, if Iman is accompanied with Islam and Ihsan. So the point being is, the reason I want to mention this is that we mentioned the definition of Iman. Now, Iman does have another definition, and that's when you say, what's the difference between Islam and Iman? And we know from our previous, you know, books and so on, that Islam and Iman, when they are separate, they have separate meaning, they mean the same thing, but when they are together, they have a slight different meaning, which is that Islam is referring to the outer actions and Iman is referring to the inner actions. So that's also, you know, another point that we can mention, inshallah. Right, the next, and also another fa'idah, is that regarding the importance of saying Iman is qawlun wa amal, even Imam Bukhari, he has a whole book in Sahih Bukhari, others as well, but especially Imam Bukhari, it's called Kitab al-Iman, the Book of Iman. All of it is a refutation against the Murji'ah. Those who take actions out of Iman, which we're going to talk about shortly. And also, he talks about the issue of Iman increasing and decreasing. Yeah. Right, the next heading that the Sheikh has is Ususu Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ati fi Bab al Iman. The foundations of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah in the chapter of Iman. Al Asas al Awwal. The first principle, Anna al Iman al Qawl wa Amal. Verily, Iman is speech and an action. وهذه القضية عندهم إجماعية قطعية. And this issue, according to them, according to Ahl al-Sunnah, إجماعية قطعية is a clear-cut إجماع. وعليها أدلة كثيرة. And it has many proofs. حتى قال الإمام ابن القيم رحمه الله until إمام ابن القيم or even until إمام ابن القيم also said وعلى ذلك ما يقارب مئة دليل من الكتاب والسنة. And upon this, and upon that, it was equivalent to 100 proofs from the Quran and Sunnah. And this is mentioned in Zad al-Ma'ad, volume 3, page 607. وَنَقَلْ الْإِجْمَاعِ. An ijma' has been transmitted على هذه القضية غير واحد. وَنَقَلْ الْإِجْمَاعِ على هذه القضية غير واحد. More than one person has transmitted ijma' regarding this issue. كالإمام البخاري, such as Imam al-Bukhari, and Imam al-Shafi'i. Imam al-Shafi'i, the Shaykh didn't mention him, I'm mentioning him. So put Imam al-Shafi'i between like brackets or something. That's something I'm adding. Okay, and I'll mention a statement of his. Al-Shafi'i, وابن أبي حاتم, I'll go back to what Shaykh Sindhi said, and Ibn Abi Hatim, and Al-Awza'i, and Al-Tabari, and Ibn Abdul Barr. So Ibn Abdul Barr, the Shaykh in the footnotes has, he says Al-Tamheed, which is an explanation of Muwatta, volume 9, page 238. حيث قال by he said, أجمع أهل الحديث والفقه, the people of fiqh and hadith have all agreed that iman is actions, statement and actions, ولا عمل إلا بنية, and there is no action except with an intention. وابن تيمية, and Ibn Taymiyyah, and the reference to Shaykh is for Ibn Taymiyyah is مجموع الفتاوى, volume 7, page 170, and also volume 7, page 296. Page 296. Okay, I think the reason the Sheikh didn't give the reference for Bukhari and others is because he's going to mention the statements now. So the Sheikh says, قال Imam al-Bukhari, Imam al-Bukhari said, I have met more than 1,000 men from the scholars in the cities, or in the countries, and I did not find that one of them differed that Iman is speech and action. He mentions this. It's mentioned by Al-Lalaka'i with authentic chain narration in Sharh Usool al-I'tiqad, volume 2, page 172. وقال الأوزاعي, Imam al-Awza'i said, وكان من مضى من سلفنا, those who preceded us from our Salaf, they did not differentiate between Iman and action, and action from Iman, and Iman from action. This is mentioned by Ibn Battah in Al-Ibana, volume 2, page 307. As for the statement of Imam Al-Shafi'i, الإمام الشافعي says, وكان إجماع من الصحابة والتابعين, and the إجماع from the صحابة and the تابعين, and those after them from who we have met, that verily Iman is speech and action and intention. لا يجزي واحد من الثلاثة عن الآخر. One is not sufficient independently from the other three. The one is not sufficient independently from the other three. And this is mentioned in Sharh Usool al-I'tiqad Ahli Sunnah al-Jama'ah, volume 5, page 886. Yeah. Obviously, the issue of Niyyah, some of you may ask what about the Niyyah. Yeah, that's mentioned in the statement of Awza'i, that in the heart, was it Awza'i's? Whose statement was it? ولا عمل إلا بنية. Oh, sorry, it was the Ibn Abd al-Barr, right at the end. Wala amala illa biniyat. It's not actually without an intention. And to be honest, the reason they don't mention intention is because no one really disagrees that iman has to be in the heart. The disagreement comes in speech and action. We're going to talk about the different sects as well shortly, inshallah. There's also Ibn Kathir, if you want to add, you can add his name in and also add his statement if you want. And he mentions this in okay, I don't have actually have a reference for this. I should do in his tafsir. I've got tafsir volume 2, page 285. I don't know which ayah that is because it's a different book that I'm using for this. But he says, and this is actually no, you can leave it from Kathir because I don't have the reference and خلاص عادي في عادي في he says وهذا مذهب جمهور الأمة and this is the مذهب the مذهب of the majority of the أمة بل حكى الإجماع عليه غير واحد in fact إجماع has been quoted on it by more than one person من الأئمة from the imams such as Imam Shafi'i and Ahmad ibn Hanbal and Abu Ubaid نعم okay let's carry on back with the Sheikh what he says Now the Sheikh, you know, he's mentioned Ijma', which shows that it's clear cut. But now he's going to mention Adillah from the Quran and Sunnah. So he says, Adillatun or Adillatu Ahli Sunnah, the proofs of Ahli Sunnah, from the Kitab. So as for from the book, number one, Allah Ta'ala, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ Surah Mu'minun, ayah number 1 to ayah number 11. فهذا دليل صريح جدا. This is a very clear cut proof على أن الأعمال من الإيمان. That actions are from إيمان. I'll explain how is it a دليل. Allah says قد أفلح المؤمنون. The word إيمان. Okay. That the مؤمنون believers they are the ones who are successful. And then after that, every single description Allah gives of the believers, it's an action. So Allah says الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون. Those that have خشوع in the صلاه. Salah is physical. والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون those who stay away from idle talk action والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون those that give zakah والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون those that protect their private parts and so on all these are actions that shows Allah is describing those of iman with actions number two قال تعالى الله سبحانه وتعالى says وما كان الله ليضيع إيمانكم Surah Baqarah ayah 143 وما كان الله ليضيع إيمانكم Allah Maybe you can check the ayah for a better translation, but something along the lines of, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not waste your iman. That is the general meaning of this ayah. So the Sheikh says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِي... Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ إِيمَانُكُمْ Your iman, i.e. your salah towards Bayt al-Maqdis. فَسَمَّ الصَّلَاةَ إِيمَانًا So Allah named salah iman. وَهَذَا مِنْ إِطْلَاقِ الْكُلِّ عَلَى الْبَعْضِ And this is naming something full, something complete upon part of its part of itself. How is this a dalil? To summarize, the believers used to, in the beginning of Islam, they used to face Masjid al-Aqsa. But then the Qibla was changed from there to the Kaaba. So when they changed, some of the Sahaba, you know, they were fearful, okay, was our Salah not accepted? Were we praying in the wrong direction? So Allah said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ Allah will not waste your iman. At your Salah that you used to pray. So Allah called Salah with the name Iman. And Iman is the whole thing. A Salah is part of Iman. And Salah is an action. So that shows that actions are from Iman. Number three, قال تعالى إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, verily, the believers are those who believe in Allah and His Messenger and then they do not have doubt and they jahadu with their wealth and themselves in the path of Allah and they are the truthful. Now, the reference is not in the book. I'll give you the reference, inshallah. Surah Hujurat, which is chapter 49, ayah number 15. Well, jihad bil mal, wal nafs, so doing your jihad with your wealth, with the wealth and with yourselves, fi sabilillah, in the path of Allah, amalun, amalu jawarih, actions of the limbs. Wa min as-sunnah, and as for, and from the sunnah, a hadith from the sunnah, is narrated on the authority of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-Iman is 70 odd or 60 odd parts. And the best of it is saying La ilaha illallah, and the lowest of it is removing something harmful from the path, and shyness is a part of Iman. Narrated by Muslim, hadith number 35. And also look at Bukhari, hadith number 9. And you know, this hadith has a lot of benefits and a lot of different weddings. We will talk about some of them. They mentioned in the Surah Thalaatha, we'll talk about them in a bit more detail later. But then the Shaykh, after mentioning hadith, he says, وَإِمَاطَةُ الْأَذَىٰ مِنْ أَعْمَالِ الْجَوَارِحِ, and removing something hard from the street is from the actions of the limbs. Number two, hadith wafd Abd al-Qais, وَفِيهَا النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the hadith of the group of Abd al-Qais, and in it, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to them, وَأَمَرَهُمْ بِالْإِيمَانِ بِاللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَحْدَهُ, and command them with believing Allah alone. قال هل تدرون ما الإيمان بالله وحده, he said, as for صلى الله عليه وسلم, do you know what iman in Allah alone is? It's that Allah and His Messenger know best. And the Sheikh, after this point, he, in the footnotes, he says, and here there is a benefit that the reference point in the definition of iman is proof from the Quran and Sunnah. Yeah, because they were asked about what is iman, and they said Allah and His Messenger know best. Meaning, that's what we go to if you want to find the meaning of iman. And then the Prophet said, "Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadar Rasulullah wa iqam as-salah wa ita'u az-zakah wa sawm Ramadan wa tu'tu al-khums min al-maghnam." All of these things, inshallah, I think you understood the Arabic words, inshallah. Do all actions, apart from the shahada, the rest are all actions of the heart. That's what the Shaykh says. Wajhu hadha al-hadith, and how do you translate this? Wajh means face, but what he means here is wajh al-hadith, how we are benefiting from this hadith is that the Prophet ﷺ did tafsir fassar al-iman, that he explained iman with the outer actions. The reference to that hadith, by the way, is Bukhari hadith number 87 and Muslim hadith number 17. Bukhari 87 hadith and Muslim 17. Number three, qawlu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at-tuhuru shatru iman, that cleanliness is half of iman. Sahih Muslim hadith number 223. Wat-tuhuru, and cleanliness is an action from the actions, a physical action. Number four, he's saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, akmal al-mu'mina iman and ahsanuhum khuluqa, those believers who are most complete in their iman are those of the best manners. That is narrated by Imam Ibn Hibban, hadith number 479, and Imam Hakim in Mustadrak, hadith number 2, and said, this hadith is authentic and has not been narrated in the two Sahih, and it is authentic upon the condition of Imam Muslim. And it's been narrated by Imam Tirmizi, hadith number 1162, and he said, hadith number Hassan Sahih, and likewise Al-Bani said the same. May Allah have mercy upon all of them. And lastly, we'll mention an athar, a narration upon one of the companions. Ammar ibn Yasir said, ثَلَاثُ مَنْ جَمَعَهُنَّ فَقَدْ جَمَعَ الْإِيمَانِ, three things, three, whoever gathers them has gathered iman. الْإِنصَافُ مِنْ نَفْسِكْ, justice from yourself. وَبَذُّ السَّلَامِ لِلْعَالَمِ, and spreading the salam to the world. وَالْإِنْفَاقُ مِنَ الْإِقْتَارِ, and spending from iqtar, from poorness. The Sheikh, and this statement is mentioned by Bukhari mu'allaqan, and volume 1/19, and it has been joined by Hafiz ibn Hajar in his book Taghliq al-Ta'liq, volume 2, 36, and what is after it. And the Sheikh does have a few footnotes regarding this hadith, but he says justice from yourself. He says, by making a person himself, but by a person making himself in front of him when he is in a position, when he is in a position of dispute. And if the haqq is for it, for himself, then he takes it. And if it was not for him, then he gives it to the person he is disputing with. And this is a quality that requires a lot of jihad of the nafs. No, we'll leave it to that, inshallah. No, you need to fight your nafs. As for sending the salam to the world, the Sheikh says, تسلم على من عرفت ومن لم تعرف. You give salam to who you know and who you do not know. Now, I believe that's also a hadith of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And والإنفاق من الإقتار, he says, تنفق في حال الفقر, that you spend in a state of poverty. No. Okay. We finish from the first principle. So now the Sheikh, he says, الأساس الثاني. The second principle, أن الإيمان يزيد وينقص, where the iman increases and decreases. And this is an issue that does not accept any, it does not accept any confusion or ambiguity from any angle, not Islamically, not intellectually, and not tangibly. The proofs upon this are many. From them are that which has clearly mentioned the words increase and decrease, and from them as that which has come with its meaning. And in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are 6 ayat with the wording increase clearly in iman. Ayat number 1, qala ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, alladhina qala lahum an-nasu inna an-nasa qad jama'u lakum fakhshawhum fazadahum imana. I'm just going to quickly give you the references, the translations, you can write yourself. That's Ali Imran 173. The ending, فَزَادَهُمْ زَادَ إِيمَانَ, the iman increased. Number 2, قَالَ تَعَالَى, Surah Tawbah 124. Surah Tawbah 124. وَإِذَا مَا أُنزِلَتْ سُورَةٌ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ أَيُّكُمْ زَادَتْهُ هَذِهِ إِيمَانًا فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَزَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَهُمْ يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ. And the reason I'm doing this, I realize I've taken, I want to do the whole thing, I don't know if I'll be able to do it now. I don't know. And number 3, قال تعالى وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. And if his ayat are recited, then the iman increases. Surah Anfal, ayah number 2. Number 4, Allah says, وَلَمَّا رَأَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا مَا وَعَدْنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. Ahzab, ayah number 22. قال تعالى, خامسا, قال تعالى هو الذي أنزل السكينة في قلوب المؤمنين ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم. سورة فتح, آية number 4. Number 6, قال تعالى ليستيقن الذين أوتوا الكتاب ويزداد الذين آمنوا إيمانا. سورة مدثر, آية number 31. Then the Sheikh says, and other ayat have come which has the meaning of increase. فمنها, and from them, قوله تعالى, the saying of Allah, والذين اهتدوا زادهم هدى وآتاهم تقواهم. Those who have been guided, we increase them in guidance. Now, Surah Muhammad, ayah number 17. Then the Shaykh says, وَمِنَ السُنَّةِ, from the sunnah, فَجُمْلَةٌ مِنَ الْأَحَادِيثِ, the many ahadith, منها, from them, number 1, قَالُوا صلى الله عليه وسلم, أَكْمَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا أَحْسَنُ الْخُلُقَى. The believers with the most complete iman are those of the best of manners. And this hadith has proceeded. Number 2, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من أحب في الله وأبغض في الله وأعطى لله ومنع لله فقد استكمل الإيمان. Whoever loves for the sake of Allah and hates for the sake of Allah and gives for Allah and prevents for Allah, then he has completed iman. This is narrated by Abu Dawood and it's his wording. Hadith number 4681 and it's authenticated by Al Albani. It has also been narrated by Imam Al Hakim. Hadith number 2694, and he said this is authentic hadith upon the conditions of the two sheikhs, i.e. Bukhari and Muslim, walam yukharrijah, and they did not narrate it. Meaning it's not in Bukhari and Muslim, but it's following their same conditions, according to him. Yeah. As for that which proves deficiency. قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما رأيت من ناقصات عقل ودين أذهب للب الرجل الحازم من إحداكم. Which is حديث بخاري حديث 298 and it says wording المسلم حديث 79. That's a hadith regarding women being deficient in iman and in intellect. والدين هو الإيمان. دين in religion أي in iman. So the Sheikh said والدين هو الإيمان. دين is iman. وهذا أصرح نص بلفظ النقصان. And this is the most clear text with the word decrease. نقصان ناقصات. That's the word. Number two, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من رأى منكم منكرا من رأى منكم فليغيره بيده. Whoever, okay, I think I missed out the word منكر here. Yeah. Whoever of you sees something evil, then let him change it with his hands. And if he's not able to, then with his tongue. And if he's not able to, then with his heart. وذلك أضعف الإيمان. And that is the weakest of iman, i.e. the lowest level of iman. And that is narrated by Imam Muslim, hadith number 49. تنبيه, attention. كل دليل دل على زيادة الإيمان فهو دليل على نقصانه. The Sheikh says, every proof that proves the increase of iman, and that is a proof that it decreases. Because everything which accepts increase, then it can accept a decrease. Hence, if iman increases in a person, then it proves that before that, he was deficient than what he is upon now. As Imam Ahmad said, إِذَا كَانَ قَبْلَ زِيَادَتِهِ تَامًا. If before his increase, it was complete, فَكُلَّمَا يَزِيدْ فَكَذَا يَنْقُصْ. Every time he increases, likewise, he decreases. That is narrated by narrated in As-Sunnah by Khalal, volume 2, page 688. وقال ابن عيينة, ابن عيينة said, ليس كل شيء, عفوا, ليس شيء يزيد إلا وهو ينقص. Nothing, there is nothing that increases except that it decreases. Narrated by Al-Sharia, by Al-Jurri, volume 2, page 605. I think the only thing you could say that that increases and never decreases is your age. That you could use as a, subhanAllah, as a, you know, as a trick, not a trick, or a riddle. Say to somebody, what increases but never decreases? It's your age, subhanAllah. Al-Athar fi dhalik, the narrations in regarding it, i.e. narrations of the companions. Verily mentioning, you know, tansis, what's the word? Mentioning the wording upon regarding this issue has come from a number of the Salaf, from the Sahaba. And in the footnotes, the Shaykh on the word Sahaba, he writes, Shaykh Abdul Razak al-Badr has counted 10 statements of the Sahaba regarding this. From them, Ibn Umar and Ibn Mas'ud and Abdullah ibn Abi Rawaha. Look at the book, the increase of Iman and decrease. That's a very good book, Ziyadat al-Iman wa Nuqsan. It's a small book, it's not that big, just about 100 pages. The Shaykh Abdul Razak al-Badr is a very good book. And the Shaykh says, from the Sahaba and Tabi'in. Verily, it has been narrated some of the Sahaba from the Umar ibn Mas'ud, Mu'adh, and Ibn Rawha. The statement, Halammu nazdadu imana. Come, let's increase in Iman. And from the most clear cut is a statement of the Sahabi, Umar ibn Habib al-Khatmi. But he al-Khatmi. Radiallahu an. And he is from the companions of. He is from the companions of the tree. Al-Iman yazidu wa yanqus. He says, Iman increases and decreases. It is said to him, and what is this increase and its decrease? He said, if we remember Allah Azza wa Jal and praise Him and do the tasbih of Him, yani, can't think of the English right now, but anyways, فَذَلِكَ زِيَادَتُ. And that is its increase. And if we are heedless and we forget and we waste, then that is its decrease. Look at Kitab al-Sunnah by Abdullah Ibn Ahmad ibn Hanbal, number 624, and also look at 680, and it's also narrated in Musannaf Ibn Abi Shaybah, number 30327. So 3327. قال الشيخ الإسلام ابن الشيخ الإسلام he says, وقد ثبت لفظ الزيادة والنقصان. The wording increase and decrease has been established upon the Sahaba, ولم يعرف فيه مخالف من الصحابة, and it is not known of anybody differing from the Sahaba. He says this in Majmu' Fatawa, volume 7, page 224. Al-Ijma', Ijma'. The Sheikh says, no, that Ijma' has taken place in Aqada. Ijma' has in Aqada or Aqada taken place upon the increase of Iman and its decrease. And it has been mentioned by a big group from the people of knowledge. SubhanAllah. Maybe, you know, if I was translating this into a book, we could, you know, potentially big group, get a better word than group. But the main thing is that you guys understand, inshallah. From them, Al-Imam al-Bukhari, Al-Imam Ahmed, Al-Imam Abu Ubaid al-Qasim ibn Salam, Al-Imam Yahya, Al-Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari, and Abu Umar ibn Abd al-Barr. And he mentions here, volume Tamheed, volume 9, page 252, and he transmitted in it from many of the Salaf. And he carries on, and Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, and Abd al-Razzaq al-San'ani, wa Abu al-Abbas ibn Taymiyyah. In Majmu' Fatawa, volume 6, page 479, and look at his book Istiqamah, page 123, and other places. Ibn al-Qayyim, and Ibn Qayyim, in Madaris al-Salikin, volume 1, page 421, and also volume 2, page 24. Rahimallahu al-Jami'. May Allah have mercy upon all of them. He says, وَجْهُ زِيَادَةِ الْإِيمَانِ وَنُقْصَانِهِ وَجْهًا. The way in how Iman increases and decreases is in two ways. Al-awwal, firstly, min jihati amri rabbi subhanahu, from the angle of the commandment of Allah. فَالْإِيمَانُ الَّذِي أَمْرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ يَزِيدُ وَيَنْقُصُ. The Iman that Allah commands with can increase and decrease. So for example, the Iman that Allah commanded with in the beginning of prophethood is not like the Iman that He has commanded at the end of the era of prophethood. كَذَلِكَ لَيْسَ الْإِيمَانُ الَّذِي Likewise, the Iman which a ignorant person is commanded with is not like the Iman that a scholar is commanded with. I'll just explain, you know, for example, in the beginning of Islam, there's no Salah, Zakah, Hajj, they weren't there. So we can say they don't have complete Iman. La. So this is from the angle of the commandment of Allah, what Allah wants from you. Okay? If a person is ignorant, doesn't know, and a person does know, then depending on the issue, obviously, but it's not just what Allah wants and expects from that person. It's not the exact same, is it? So from the aspect of the angle of the commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Athani, the second, from the angle of the action of the slave. And that is that everyone, he feels from himself, tafawut al-iman. Tafawut means to be like, keep changing. You know, the changing of iman, changing of levels, going up and down. So sometimes Iman increases, sometimes it decreases. So Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he says, may Allah have mercy upon him. It's a very long statement. Mention Majmu' Fatawa. The Shaykh puts a reference at the end. I'll see if I'm able to translate the whole thing. He says, وَالْإِيمَانِ يَتَفَاضَلُ مِنْ جِهَةِ الشَّارِعِ. Iman, يَتَفَاضَلُ, it goes up and down from the angle of the legislator, i.e. Allah. So not everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded with. فَلَيْسَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ كُلَّ عَبْدٍ. So not what everything that Allah commands every slave. So not what Allah commands with every slave is what Allah commands others with. Another Iman which is obligatory upon every slave is obligatory upon others. Rather, in the beginning of Islam, a man could be a mu'min with complete Iman, deserving of reward, if he did what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made obligatory upon him, even if the detailed belief, tasdeeq, with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought down from the Quran did not take place from him. And he did not fast Ramadan. And he did not do Hajj of the house, the Kaaba. Just as the one who believes in our time, he has complete Iman, and if he dies before the time of Salah enters upon him, he died with complete Iman, which is obligatory upon him. And just as the one who is deserving of a reward upon his Iman, just as he is rewarding, he is deserving of the reward upon his Iman with that. As for after the revelation of what has been revealed from the Quran and the obligation of what Allah and His Messenger have obligated from the obligations, and he is able to do that action, then he is not deserving of reward solely بمجرد ما كان يستحق solely due to what he was deserving of reward before that. That's why he will say to these people, he was not a mu'min with what he was a mu'min before that. Meaning, in that time he was considered a mu'min, but in this time no. And this is because Iman, which has been legislated for this, is greater than the Iman legislated for this, from this person to this person, or this state to this state. And also the one who is able to do Hajj, which is obligatory upon him, is that which is not obligatory upon the one who is not able. And the companion of wealth, obligatory upon his upon him is Zakah, is that which is not obligatory upon the poor. ونظائره متعددة. And its likes, i.e. other examples like this, are many. وَأَمَّا تَفَاصِيلُهُ مِنْ جِهَةِ الْعَبْدِ. As for its detail regarding the angle of the slave, then sometimes this happens from إِقْرَار وَالْعَمَلِ, you know, believing in the heart and action. بِأَعْظَمِ مِمَّا يَقُومُ بِهِ هَذَا. Greater than what this person, this has done. And every person knows in his heart from the affairs that they differ, يتفاضل, up and down. Until even a man, he will find inside himself more love for Allah and His Messenger and awe of Allah and hope for His mercy and reliance upon Him and sincerity for Him in certain times. I mean, you can feel yourself like in Ramadan, you have more Iman than outside of Ramadan. And that's the end of the statement of Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah. He mentions this in Majmu' Fatawa, volume 18, page 227 to 278. Then the Shaykh, he says, and we can summarize from his statement, may Allah have mercy upon him, a tangible proof in that, which is that everyone feels the increase of Iman and its decrease in other than it, and even inside of himself. And that becomes clear when looking in the state of Iman in the month of Ramadan and the last 10 nights, for example. The next subheading, Sheikh mentions, Asbab Ziyat al-Iman, the ways of increasing Iman. The ways of increasing Iman. For increasing Iman, there are many different ways. In reality, they come back to one point, which is at-ta'ah, which is obedience. And this is why you'll find that the people of knowledge say regarding Iman that increases with good deeds and it decreases with bad deeds. In the footnotes, the Sheikh writes, and from those who have mentioned this, Sheikh Al-Islam in Majmu' Fatawa, volume 1, page 133, and in his book Istiqamah, page 438, and Ibn Qayyim in Madarij al-Salikin, volume 1, page 421, and also volume 2, page 24, and Ibn Abdul Barr in his book in the Tamheed, volume 9, 252, and he has transmitted from many of the Salaf regarding this from them, Imam Shafi'i and Ahmed and Al-Thawri, and Sufyan Al-Thawri, and other than them. The Sheikh, he says, the relationship or connection between the increase of Iman and ta'ah and obedience becomes apparent with the following explanation. The Sheikh, he says, The more a believer increases in good deeds, the more his outward iman increases. And like that, his inner iman also increases. And if that is like that, then the limbs then the limbs arise with obedience. So the link between the increase of iman and actions of good deeds have a synchronized relation or link. For verily, the increase of iman, if iman increases, the limbs stand or arise with obedience. And if obedience increases, then iman increases. And this shows that there is a talazum, necessity, between the outer iman and the inner iman. So whoever does a good deed, then its sister will call it to do another good deed, and like that. If you do a good deed, your iman increases, because your iman increases, you want to do another good deed. So it's like when you do a good deed, another good deed was called, saying, you know, do this good deed, and so on. قَالَ تَعَالَى Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدًى وَأَتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ Those who have guidance will be increased in guidance. Okay? And they will be given taqwa. Surah Muhammad, ayah number 17. Issue. If we said iman increases in good deeds, then you should know that the matter, يَتَفَاوَدُ فِي الزِّيَادَةِ know that the matter is that the increase differs depending on a number of different factors. Sheikh Muhammad ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah said, verily iman increases depending on the quality of the action and the type of action, the quality of the action and its type and its amount. So the more the action is better in quality, the more the increase in iman is higher. And the quality of iman is dependent upon sincerity and mutaba'ah, like how well you follow the sunnah. And as for the type of action, then the obligatory is better than the masnoon, the recommended. And some obediences are more emphasized and better than others. And every time a act of obedience is better, then the increase of iman is more. In the footnotes, the Sheikh says, this is outwardly. As for inwardly, then Sheikh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah says in volume 22, page 309, a person could rectify his religion upon the action, upon a less virtued action without doing the more virtuous action, and it is better for him. So just as Hajj in the right for the women is better than jihad, and some people reading or I think reciting Quran in this context is better, is more beneficial for him than salah, and for some zikr is more beneficial for them than reading, and for some doing ijtihad, doing working more hard in dua to complete his need is better for him than doing zikr whilst he is neglectful. Basically saying that generally, yeah, the better action that you do, that's known as better, that's going to increase your iman. But it could be subjective and it could differ depending on the situation and the type of person. And it's back to what Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen was saying. Then he says, and as for the amount of actions, a lot of actions. Okay, even before when I said amount, change that to a lot. He says, as for a lot of actions, then iman increases with it. Because the action is from iman, so there's no doubt that iman increases with its increase. It's mentioned in Fathur Rabbil Bariyah, Talkhis al-Hamawiyah, page 104-105. That's a very small textbook. You can find it. We studied it in Medina. it's got Ibn Uthaymeen explained that text himself. He summarized basically the book of Shaykh al-Islam, which is known as Al-Hamawiyyah. Okay, issue. Now, subhanAllah, this took way longer than I thought it would be. It's good, alhamdulillah. I'm going to stop here, inshallah, because Maghrib's in 10 minutes and I have a dars after Maghrib, so I'm not prepared for that. So I'm just going to look at that, inshallah. So we stop here today. And we'll carry on in the next lesson from this. And, you know, what we're going to take is that we're going to finish off the topic of increase and decrease of iman. We'll take the third principle. After the third principle, we're going to take the issue of, can we say, I have iman, inshallah? Can we say that or not? And then we're going to take some of the benefits of sticking to what the Salaf have said in regards to iman. And then we're going to talk about those who differ in iman and what are their proofs. And, you know, how to refute them, inshallah. So, inshallah, we'll take the next lesson. We'll stop here. Subhanakallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.